As I spend day after day confined to my home, my thoughts are anything but confined. They travel at lightning speed around the world to China, Italy, Israel. I see shopping malls, airlines, schools. Everything has been completely shut down. I have so many questions. After all of this is over, which businesses will survive? Which institutions will survive? Which of us will survive? And will it ever be over? Will the world ever be the same? No one has the answers right now. We're all in total darkness. Will someone please shed a little light? Ah, light. A little candle can go a long way in a dark world. I always wondered if that's why Jews are so obsessed with candles and fire. Think about it. We've been lighting fires for thousands of years. We bring in Shabbat with fire. We take out Shabbat with fire. And we do the same for Rosh Hashanah, Yom Kippur, and every other holiday around the year. On Hanukkah, we spend a whole week obsessively lighting candles. On Lag BaOmer, we set the whole world ablaze. In every synagogue, we have that little everlasting flame. And of course, when someone passes away, we light a little candle to remember them. What is this obsession with fire? Maybe we're trying to access a certain type of light, a light far brighter than any physical light, that spiritual light that's existed since the beginning of time. You see, if you go back in time, way back, you'll find that both scientists and creationists remarkably agree on something, that everything in the universe started with light. If the sun didn't exist yet, where did this light come from? This light, dear friends, was the powerful light of the spiritual world. It was the fiery soul that exists within you and me. Everything in the physical world is like a mirror, reflecting the deeper spiritual elements of life. So why is the human soul compared to a candle? Look at it this way. The world was created with four elements: water, air, earth, and fire. Each of these elements naturally has its own unique direction. Water flows downward. Air moves in all directions. Earth is passive, unmoving without an outside force. And fire's nature is to rise like a human soul. Flames must breathe, change, grow. They strive against the darkness and ultimately one day fade away, all the while rising, facing upwards, no matter which way the candle turns. The flickering of candlelight reminds us of the precious fragility of life, a life that must be cherished, focused on the things that really matter. When I light my Shabbat candles, it's my unique reminder of the light in the world that is often so hard to see, that I'm just too distracted to notice. It's in the moment that my hands pass over the tip of the dancing flames that I feel the warmth of the fiery soul that connects us all. And you know what? When I light my candles, I think of the millions that came before me who lit their candles in the darkest parts of our history. And when I think of them, I realize I'm not alone. I am part of the greatest legacy of what it means to be a light unto the nations. So this Shabbat, let us live that legacy and be the light.